Hi guys, my name is Vivek, and in this video tutorial we are going to learn the difference between local and global partition index. Guys, if you have not seen my first few videos on partitioning, I will highly recommend that you watch those videos first. You will be able to appreciate this video in a better manner once you have completed those. There is another prerequisite for this video. At least you should have a basic understanding of indexes. If you don't have that, I have made few videos on indexing as well. I will highly recommend that you complete those videos and then come back to this. If you have a basic understanding of partitioning and indexing, I will make sure that I try to explain it in as simple manner as possible so that you grasp the concept easily. Now let's go ahead and see the difference between local and global partition index with our table transaction partition index demo. So I've created a table with three columns, ID, name and transaction date, and I've used interval partitioning on my column transaction date where I'm creating monthly partitions. Now as soon as I go ahead and execute it, it will go ahead and create a table that is interval partition. Now when we talk about local partition index, there are two types of index: local prefix index and non-prefix index. What are local prefix index? Local prefix index are index that are partitioned using the same partition key and they have the same range boundary. This range boundary concept remains same for non-prefix index as well, but there is a specific requirement for prefixed index that the key I have used to create local prefix index, it should be same as the partition key. And if I'm using a composite key to partition my table, then my local prefix indexed key should be the leftmost combination of columns. So here in this particular example, I have used a single or simple key. I have used transaction date. So I'm creating an index on the column transaction date and I've specified the keyword local. That explains Oracle that I'm creating a local partition index on my interval partition table. Now since the column that I've used is the column using which I've partitioned my table, so this is a local prefixed index. And the vital thing to know about local indexes that they share the same boundary as the table. We will see in a moment what exactly this means in a more simple manner. Then I have created another index which is a non-prefixed index. That means the column on which I have created the index is either not part of the partition key or is not a combination of the leftmost columns of the partition key of the table. So in this particular example, I have partitioned my table using transaction date column. While I have created this local index on ID column, which has nothing to do with my table partitioning key. So it's a local but non-prefixed index. And the important thing to note about this is that it will share the same boundary as my table. It's just that when I go ahead and use this predicate in my query, Oracle will not do partition pruning. Instead, it will use this particular index to fetch the data. We will understand in a moment what exactly this means. So as I mentioned, when I use local prefixed index, Oracle is going to use partition pruning, and that's not the case with non-prefixed index since it's not the part of the partition key, and if it is a part of the partition key, then it's not the leftmost part. And guys, I have made a tutorial on indexing where I have mentioned that why order is so important when you are doing indexing on composite columns or multiple columns. You can go ahead and refer that to understand why local non-prefixed index will not use partition pruning. Now, right now, when I have just created the table and created the index, I have not inserted any data into my table. If I go ahead and query my user segments table and try to identify the segment allocated to my table and these indexes, I will see that no segment has been allocated as of now. If I go ahead and run this, it's going to give me null or zero. This is one thing important to note. Though I have created a partition table, though I have created local index on that particular table, till the time I don't insert the data, there is no space allocated to those partitions. Now what I'm going to go ahead is, I'm going to go ahead and enter some random data. So I've written this query where I'm inserting 10,000 rows. I've used row number as my ID column. I'm inserting a random string of length 6th, and I have used this decode statement to actually insert dates that will belong to three range: one for the current month, one for the next month, and one for the month after that. So right now we are in February. We will have certain rows for February. We will have certain rows for March and we will have certain rows for April. So as soon as I go ahead and execute this query, Oracle is going to go ahead and generate three segments for my table. But what exactly will happen to my index? We saw that though the index have been created, if the table didn't had any data, there was no segments allocated to that. Now that we have inserted the data in the table and three segments have been created to the table, we will see that three segments will be created for both the index, both the local prefix index and the non-prefix index. So as soon as I go ahead and execute this, three segments have been created for my table and the same segments have been replicated for my prefixed index and non-prefix index. Now earlier I mentioned that when I'm talking about local indexes, they share the same boundary. And what exactly that meant? Let's go ahead and see that. So when I inserted the data, three partitions were created. First partitions where the data was less than 28th Feb, the second partition where the data was less than 31st March, and the third partition where the data was less than 30th April. So as soon as these partitions were created, Oracle also created three partitions each for the local prefixed index and non-prefixed index with the same boundary. That means for the prefixed index, a partition was created where the values pointing were less than 28th February. Another partition was created between 1st March and 31st March, and the third partition had values from 1st and 30th April. This was done both for prefixed and non-prefixed index. One thing I want to mention here is that local partition index are automatically maintained by Oracle. So we just gave this index, we created the index as soon as we inserted the data in our table, multiple interval partitions were created corresponding to that automatically. My local partitions were also created for the index. So if I use this command to drop a partition from my table, it's going to reduce a segment from my table and it will drop a segment from my both indexes as well. That means for local partition index, Oracle does the maintenance, which is why they are easy to maintain. And guys, they are very commonly used in data warehouse. Whenever you have tables with huge data and you partition them based on your requirement, you frequently create local prefixed index and local non-prefixed index. And I'm guessing that if you're working in a data warehouse that has more than 5 or 10 terabytes of data with multiple table having huge amount of data that are partitioned, if you go ahead and query your data warehouse, you have created a lot of local index, both prefixed and non-prefixed, based on your business requirement. So just to quickly recap, here in this case, I had partitioned my table using interval partitioning. I had created two index on my table, one which shared the same key, that's called the prefix index, and another on a different column, but I used the local keyword. So my indexes shared the same boundary as my partition tables. Now let's go ahead and discuss about global prefix partition index. For global partition index, the index boundary is usually not same as the table partition boundaries. That means a single partition of index can go ahead and point to multiple partitions. And there is one other important thing. When you are partitioning your indexes globally, you can only use range or hash strategy to partition your index, but that's not the case with the table. Your table can be partitioned using any strategy, but when you are partitioning your index using global strategy, you can only use range or hash partitioning strategy. Guys, there is another thing that you should not get confused with. There is something called global index on a partition table, which means you have a partition table, but you are creating a single index on that. This is how exactly it looks like. So you are creating an index on the ID column, but you are creating a global index. Now, when we saw that when we created a local index on the same column, as multiple partitions were being introduced, the index partitions were also increased. There was a one-to-one relationship between local index and the partition of the table. That's not the case with global index. When I go ahead and specify this particular index, Oracle is just going to create one index with a single partition or segment that will have data pointing to multiple partitions. So this is how the syntax of global partition index looks like. I'm creating a global partition index and I'm using range strategy to partition my index. The column that I've used is ID column and I've created four partitions. The first partition index will contain values less than 100. The second will have values between 100 and 200. Third, 200 and 300. And the final partition will have values greater than 300 till the max value. So I've created four partitions here. In case of local index, we saw that initially no partitions were being created. Dynamically, as we inserted the data and on runtime, the interval partitions were being generated. At the same time, the local partitions were being generated for the index as well. But when I'm using global partitioning strategy, as soon as I go ahead and execute this statement, I will have four segments or four partitions allocated for this particular index. When I talked about local partition index, I mentioned that one local partition index maps to data from one local partition table, from one local partition of the table. That's not the case of the global partition index. They have usually different boundaries. That means the boundary of my global partition index will vary from the boundary of my table partition. This means that a particular global partition index may have values corresponding to multiple partition. For example, here the ID column with value less than 100 will have certain data where the dates are less than 28th Feb and certain data where the dates are less than 31st March. The same goes for the ID 200 as well. It may have certain data for dates less than 31st March and certain data for dates less than 30th April. And guys, this is one of the most important difference between local and global index, that our local index share the same boundary as our table, while that's not the case with global index. They can have data in different partitions, and this is actually a challenge also when it comes to global index. So Oracle does not maintain global index on its own. We saw that when we dropped a particular partition, the local index corresponding to that particular partition was also dropped, making it easy to manage. That's not the case with global index. If I go ahead and drop one of these table partitions, instead of dropping a particular index partition, it's going to make the entire index unusable. And that can actually cost you a lot of performance, because now your index will not be used. Even if you are specifying that particular column in your query predicate, as soon as you move or you drop your partition, your entire global index will become unusable. So when are global index usually used? I have seen that majority of the times they are used in OLTP systems, but that does not mean that they cannot be used in OLAP systems. They are used in OLAP system as well. For example, you have partitioned your table using interval partitioning and you're creating a partition for every month. Now in a report, you want to fetch data corresponding to 36 months, but you only want to pick data corresponding to the initial 100 IDs or initial 100 employees. In that case, you can go ahead and create a global partition index on your ID column, and that is going to give you much faster results. A lot of people have this misconception that global partition index are only used for OLTP system. That's not the case. It completely depends upon your use case. Though it is a fair statement to say that local partition index, both prefixed and non-prefixed, are very useful for decision support system and data warehouse, because they provide you this manageability functionality along with performance improvement, which actually comes in pretty handy if you have big tables in your huge database. Now, since you don't have a one-to-one relationship between your indexes and your partition, so the partition pruning will not be utilized. Global index or global partition index is not going to utilize partition pruning. There is a big problem with global index and global partition index. If I go ahead and drop a partition or move a partition, the entire index will become unusable. For example, as a part of month-end process, you drop a particular partition from your table and suddenly your reports are performing poor because this particular global index has become unusable. Now, while dropping or moving a partition from the table, there is an option to rebuild the index. But the challenge with that is that though drop partition is a DDL statement, Oracle will actually go ahead and execute it as a DML statement. So one important thing that we have learned right now is that as soon as we go ahead and drop a partition or move a partition, instead of automatically rebuilding the index, Oracle is going to make it invalid or unusable. That means Global and Global Partition Index are not managed by Oracle. You have to explicitly manage it. And if I go ahead and issue this command to actually update my global index, so although drop partition and alter table are DDL statement, but since I have associated update global index with this particular statement, instead of doing truncate or drop, it's going to do delete, which means it's going to generate all those redo logs. It's going to log all that data, and that is going to consume a lot of time. And trust me guys, if you have a huge table with millions or billions of rows and you drop partitions on a daily or a weekly basis, it's actually becoming very painful to maintain global index. That's why Oracle actually came up with a solution in 12c where if you go ahead and drop or move a partition, your global index will not become invalid. It will stay valid, and during a later stage you can actually go ahead and maintain your index. So if I have to do a quick 1 minute recap between local and global partition index, local prefix partition index share the same boundary and same partition key as my table, which is not the case with global index. One partition of global partition index can actually point to multiple partitions of my table. Global partition index are not managed by Oracle, and if I go ahead and drop a partition from my table, my global partition index will become unusable. And if I go ahead and use update global index, instead of treating it as a DDL, it's going to treat this particular command as a DML, which is going to take huge time. And this particular issue has been resolved in 12c. We will talk about that in a later video. This is not the case with local index. As soon as I go ahead and drop a partition, both the local prefixed index and non-prefixed index will also be dropped. That means local partition index are explicitly managed by Oracle, which is not the case with global partition index. Local partition index are used extensively in decision support system and data warehouse, while global partition index are usually preferred in OLTP systems. Though it will be unfair to say that they cannot be used in OLAP system at all, I just narrated a case where we are using global partition index in our OLAP system as well. So guys, though this is a slightly advanced topic, hopefully after seeing this video, at least you got a basic idea what are local partition index, what are global partition index, what is a global index on a partition table, and that kind of stuff. If you still have any question related to this particular tutorial, please go ahead and drop in a comment and I'll try to reply as soon as possible. Thanks a lot guys for your time tonight, and I'll see you in the next one.